What in seven hours is that?
Tell them your name.
Samuel Tarly.
This is John Bradley, best known for playing Samuel Tarly in Game of Thrones, who was last seen in Season 6 having his own Beauty and the Beast moment at the Citadel in Old Town, ready to begin his training as the Maester for the Night's Watch. John was born John Bradley West in Manchester, England, and attended the Manchester Metropolitan School of Theatre. After being there for 3 years, he performed 2 monologues at a showcase, was approached by an agent afterwards, who then sent him out for his first audition, Game of Thrones. After a callback, he got the part of Samuel Tarly, a character who, by all accounts, should not have lasted this long in the cutthroat world of Westeros. When we first meet Sam, he's cowardly, inexperienced, the embarrassment of his family. However, like any good character, the best part is seeing him change, grow a backbone, find his strengths, discover his confidence. He's a character you're meant to underestimate, an underdog. So what other roles has John played? When you play a character that's so beloved, there's a tendency for casting directors to hire you to play similar roles in other projects. So there have been some Samuel-esque characters, such as John's role as the gentle, well-meaning Giovanni de' Medici, who was made cardinal at a young age in the series Borgia.
I'm named a cardinal.
He had a brief appearance as a kindly room service attendant in Man Up, and he also played King Arthur's horse groomer in a couple episodes of Merlin.
Afternoon, Sir Knight. Horses shod and watered as requested.
You are Tyr Seward.
I am Sir Gawain. Is the king not pleased with my work?
Oof. Poor guy. On the other hand, he's played roles that have subverted audiences' expectations by being very much the opposite of Samuel. It's fun to see him play a mean character, like a vindictive fast food manager in a couple episodes of Shameless.
For f- sake, how's it my fault if 2 fat parcels got stuck in the door of the 105?
Oh, bad language on the premises. That is your first verbal.
Or a confident, slightly ruthless attorney in The Last Dragon Slayer.
You seem a stranger, therefore not old enough to legally sign a contract invalidating any contract your client believes she has with this agency. Consequently, I cite the 1743 Act of Magical Licensing indemnifying wizards against casual magical damage. Finally, this.
John's name is undoubtedly going to always be synonymous with Sam, but he can obviously play any character someone throws at him. He's a talent who has a bright future of surprising audiences with his unique, natural characterizations.